So I'm here with Olivia Marshall from Presenter Ladies TV. Welcome back, Olivia. So we're talking about coronavirus and we've got a local angle, haven't we? Because I know you've been talking to businesses. We've all been talking to businesses, haven't we? What have they been saying on the doorstep? Because it's very difficult for local businesses, local pubs, clubs, venues, theatres, because obviously we've got the new advice from the government saying that advising people not to go to venues, pubs, etc., clubs. So what are you hearing on the street?
Mm-hmm. Well, some businesses that I've spoken to, they're able to work and have their workforce work from home, so that's a lot easier for them. But obviously, of course, for places like pubs and cafes, they rely on footfall coming into their business, so it's a lot harder for them. And I know that without real guidance from the government, a lot of them are really concerned at the moment, particularly in Brighton. Obviously, 25% of businesses here are reliant upon tourism, and with restrictions upon travel, I know that a lot of business owners will be feeling very anxious.
Yeah, it is. Do you think that? I mean, I know you've spoken to particular businesses, didn't you? You spoke to, and via Skype. So Skype's really coming to the fore, isn't it? Because it means that you don't have to have that. You can do the distancing, social distancing, but also still speak to people. So who have you been speaking to and what they've been saying?
I spoke to Ed Barton, who's a small business owner in Brighton, and he's taken the decision to self-isolate because a few people that he's been in contact with had coronavirus-like symptoms. He hasn't been tested himself. He's personally feeling very, very well. But he's just thinking about protecting himself, his family and his workforce. And he's lucky that he can work from home. All of his employees can work from home. He can do business calls. Like I say, he did a Skype call with me. So his business isn't suffering too much, but he's very community minded and he's concerned about other small businesses. A lot of his friends own small businesses, cafes, bars, and he knows that they're feeling very anxious and he's also very concerned for them.
Yeah. And I know we're going to listen to the Skype chat now, so let's go and take a listen in to the interview. Okay, so that's what the business owner said. So, I mean, what is he going to isolation? Do we know how long for?
Yeah, he's self-isolating now. He didn't say how long he's going to be doing that for. I think he's just very concerned about the community, and because he's been in contact with people who have coronavirus-like symptoms, he doesn't want to put anybody else at risk. So he's just staying at home with his girlfriend, minimising his contacts. He's going out to buy food and stuff, but he isn't going to bars and clubs like the government have advised us not to do.
Yeah. This is going to revolutionise the way that people work, because I think once people start working from home, they're going to want to do that even when we come out of this kind of crisis, really. More and more people are going to work from home because they're going to think that it works for them. That can only be a good thing, can't it, really?
Yeah, I mean, it's probably going to have a real impact on everyone's mental health and how we deal with everything day to day. So what the long-term impacts of this will be, I guess we'll just have to wait and see.
Yeah, we've got all the new business measures that the government brought in. We can expect a bit more action from the government. We know that the French government have got a big package for all business owners. Emmanuel Macron announced that this week. So we can expect a few more announcements from government, can't we, I think, down the line? Because businesses, as we said at the start, they're going to struggle.
Yeah, I think anger is growing. And I think every day everyone will be watching the daily announcements that the government are making, Boris Johnson, and when the Chancellor makes his announcements with him too. Yeah, the French government have promised billions of pounds for businesses. Emmanuel Macron has said that no business will suffer as a result of this pandemic. But the government haven't made a promise like that as of yet. I think it's just wait and see. But businesses will definitely be looking for more reassurance in the future.
Yeah, OK. So we'll leave it there for now. And I know that we've been working on it. We've been discussing the Mutual Aid, Brighton Mutual Aid. It's an organisation that's been set up online. And now we're going to watch a VT about how people can get involved and help each other out. So we're going to see that now. Thanks for chatting, Olivia. Is that all right?